attention to what the servants did. I believe it's important when you preach a text that you preach about everyone in the text. And even if you don't understand why a person is mentioned in the text, I believe that everyone is strategically placed in the text. And so as a preacher, you must mention everyone that's placed in the text. Because you never understand how God is going to speak to someone by a character in the text. There's one more character in this text who doesn't have a name. And you guys know how I feel about characters without names. It always intrigues me. There's a character in the text who doesn't have a name, but he has a title. And he has a speaking part. This last character, he's called the Master. And here's what the Master says. The Master says, most people bring out the good wine first. And then they bring out the bad wine. But he says, you have brought out the bad first. And then you brought out the good. What the Master is saying is that you have saved the best for last. Bethel A.M.E. Church, I've come by to say this morning, that the Master has said that he has saved the best for last. And that weeping may endure for the night, but joy comes in the morning because God saved the best for last. And that all you've been through, that it wasn't meant to break you, that it wasn't meant to kill you, that it wasn't meant to destroy you, but God is saving the best for last. I come by to say to someone that the rest of your life will be the best of your life because God is saving the best for last. And that all the marital problems and all the relationship problems and all the financial problems and all the medical problems, it was all because God is saving the best for last. I come by to say that I can see Joseph, and I can see Joseph looking up from the pit, and I can see Joseph looking at his brothers, but I hear God say, don't worry, I'm saving the best for last. And then I see Joseph sold into slavery, then I see Joseph with chains around his hands and feet, but I hear God say, don't worry, I'm saving the best for last. And then I see Joseph arrested, then I see Joseph in jail for a crime he didn't commit, but I hear God say, don't worry about it, I'm saving the best for last. Then I see Joseph head governor, then I see Joseph ruling over all of Egypt, and I hear God say, I told you I was saving the best for last. But then I see Jesus, and I see Jesus being beaten, I see Jesus being bruised, I see Jesus being whipped, and I hear God say, don't worry about it, I'm saving the best for last. And then I see that old rugged cross, and then I see him lifted high, and then I see him stretched wide, and I hear God say, don't worry about it, I'm saving the best for last. And then I see him die on that cross, and then I see him take him down, and then I see them wrap his body in linen, but I start to worry, but I hear God say, don't worry about it, I'm saving the best.
Yes, Lord.
And regardless of how hard it may seem, no know that we serve a God who sometimes saves the best.
That's all right now.
For last.
That's all right. Praise God for whom all blessings flow.